Hello, hello, test, 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 mic, 1, 2, 3. Hello, I want to show you how to slice a PSD file into an HTML template. This tutorial is for beginners. Okay, now let's open our PSD file. Find it and here in our draft, what we're going to do is to slice these things into sections. Let's go for the wrapper, for the header, the menu, the banner, the footer. Okay, so first things first, we're going to slice this thing. Should be saved for web. Let's put the HTML folder. Create a new folder called images. So we're going to save it there. Header. Banner, the content, footer. The next thing we're going to do is to get a tile for our background. So we're going to create a tile for it. So after this one, let's close, and now let's open our Dreamweaver. Let's create a new HTML file, save it under index.html. Now let's create the CSS for it. Let's name it style. Style.css. Now go to HTML5, HTML style. Okay, now let's create the sections. just separate it. The header. This is just for a while. Maybe we can call this one as a scaffolding stage. This one is a banner. Nope, but we can put the banner inside content. So content, and inside content is the banner. For the footer, so the footer, so adding the CSS page dot header dot menu dot content that footer, that's the thing, that content, that main content. Okay, and for the page we're going to have a width of 1000px and margin is 0 auto, so it will be on the center. The background image should be background. Okay, let's test. Let's test this thing. Oh, okay, looks good. And then should have the border for body is 0 and the margin is 0. Pixels, px, pixels. By the way, this is my Chrome extension. So these are all images, so we're going to apply now the HTML for the header menu, and for the banner it can be a JPEG or an image, a flash, but for this contents it should be text. So here we go. This is our web page logo. Oops. And then from here, we're going to delete this one because we're going to create a two column header. This one here will be the location for the logo. It should have an alt for SEO, class left, class right, class clear. Okay, and here in our CSS should put this as a that left or the left side, right, and then clear for the left side. Yes, for the left side we float it left. Float right, then clear both. Okay, so we double check the headers height, which is this one, 1000 by 74. So the headers. By 74px. Okay, let's check. Okay, and then the background for the header should be white. Okay, and then should have a. The logo should have a padding for top we give it 30, for the left is 0, bottom is 0, and the left side is 30. Double check. Okay, I think we should reduce the padding for the top. Okay, now we put the contact as the header's contact as, yeah, which is should be a text file, should be a home phone plus 65 or imaginary number. Then should put it on P, call this info or contact info. Or maybe we can leave it like this. Because we're going to format it through here. Font family is Arial. Let's double check our Photoshop. What's the right? What's the correct font for our? Should be Arial bold 25 point. Should be so that we're going to take out the border and the margin of B. Okay, and then padded thing, the right padding should be 30 and the top padding should be 20, so it should look like this: 20px, 30px, 0px, 0px for the top left, top right, bottom, and then left side. There it goes. I think let's make this thing 24. Okay, so now we have the logo and the contact, but the logo should be clickable, so we put it like this. Then border should be 0. Okay, and then the menu. The menu should be semantically laid out, so it should be a li stuff. This is the home, this is the about us, this is the products, how do I spell products, services, this is the contact us. Okay, how to format that one? Okay, wait a minute, we should make sure have the correct, so this is 1000 by 48, so the correct resolution. The background should be white. Top color should be almost white, thin and solid. Okay, check it again, bang. Okay, now let's format the navigation UL. And this is for the LI. And this is for the A. For the hover. Guess we're going to create clickable links. We're going to make these things as clickable links. This one margin is 0, padding is 0, display is inline, color is black, hover is white. Check. Okay, haven't specified the font. The font would be still Arial. Font size would be 16, and Font weight should be bold. Text decoration should be none, and then padding right should be 30, and then maybe we should pad this down and left by 30, down by 20, 0px, and 30px. Okay, maybe to look at it. Okay, now we do the background. No, we should pad. Padding is 5px, 10px, 5px, 10px. And then background color is black if it hovers. Okay, now we have an effect, so we're going to create a special status like active, so meaning this A, if this A is active, the CSS will be like this. And we are going to create the home, make it as the active one. Let's check it again. Okay, so it's the server side's duty to generate which one is active if we're going to select about us, products and services, or contact us. So now we're going to convert the content. So the content be this. So this is the dimensions, 1000 by 267. It's the main content. Width is still 1000. Height, so we should give it a minimum height of 2276. Minimum height because this height is still extendable if the user will put more content. Okay, for this we're going to delete this one. Now we're going to create three columns. Should name this as class left, class middle, and class right, and then the clear one. Okay, so within our main content should create that left, that right, that left, that middle, that right, that clear. Okay, so we're going to float this one left. This one still be left, this one floated. Some guys they floated right, but I floated left still. Then clear it both. I float all of them left. And then each one for the title. B for the content. Okay. Now we're going to select the text for all of them. Select the text, copy, paste, paste here. This one is also copy, paste, and the lorem ipsum thing. This is the content that's gonna be filled in by your clients. So what's the width? The width for each column is 2, maybe let's put it 300. So width for this one is 300. Width for this one is 300. This one is 300, this one is 300. And then for each one, and then B, we're going to make should not be bold, should be just 14. There's no padding. Color is black, background is no background. Sun bold, padding, margin should be 0, colors black, margin is 0. Let's have a try. Oops. Okay, and why is it that there is no background for the main content? I think should put it in the page itself. Page should have a background of white. Background color white. Okay, and then I think the banner we should take away the border. This way. We didn't have a border. Create the border from the page. Okay. And then, yep, we should. Main content should. Padding left should be 30. Okay, and then the guys here should have a padding right, should have at least 20, and then 20. See? Okay, and then the text alignment should be justified for all of them. Maybe we should put it here. Just put it here, and all of them will align. Okay. Now, I think this is a small one. It should be 24. Oh, there you go. And the text, the letter, the line height should be 24, should be 18. Okay. Original design. Actually, the text align should only be in P, so that it will have text align the H1 also. Now, then the margin and padding for H1 should be, padding should be 20px, 0px, 0px, and then 30px. 30px, and then nope, should be 0px. Okay, that is it. Now we're going to convert this footer into a text file also. So what is the height? Height is 86. So delete this one. Footer, the footer's height is 36. Let me check it again. It's 86, not 36. It's 86. And then, yep. Then we're going to create a two column again. Should be dev, should be class left, class right, class clear. As left is ULLI, oops, should have a link first for it. Should be the copyright at copy 2010 HTML draft. Should be the home, should be the about us, should be the products, services, should be the contact us. For the right, it's the logo of our footer. Where is it? Yes. To save this one first. My God. Save this one first. Let's see this one. For the Philippine based web design. Okay. Then we're going to put that all in here. Them should have an alt logo. Alternative is okay. Now we're going to be then solid. Okay, and then because we didn't specify the left nor the left. Go this thing. The font size is supposed to be smaller, and there the color should be black. Then the UL should bad 0, I should bad 10, 10 by 0px, 0px, I 0px. 30px. Oops. Then how about this one? Why is it like that? I think it's because I love you. This one should be cut here. And then they should pad right 30px. I think 30, and then the height for the footer should increase, it should be 96. Oops, 96. 96. Okay. And then we should make the footer length should be font weight, should be bold. And then the border right should be color, should be this, then solid. Okay, and then padding left should be 20, should be 10. Okay. Oops, I think maybe should padding right also should be 20. Okay, and then the left. For this one, the solution for that is I think this one is for here. And then this one is for the that last should have further equals 0px. And then we will name this one as class last. This one is for here. Okay, that's it. I have converted our HTML to a very nice and clean web standard. HTML markup design. So if we do the view source, very clean to the eye and very clean for the robots. Next video is for how we can search engine optimize this web page. Bye bye.